Assalamualaikum, my dear students. Welcome back to your social studies recorded class. I'm your teacher, Ms. Jaziba Khurram from the Smart School, Sir Sayyid Ahmed Khan Campuses and Gulistan Johar Campus. This is your grade 3 social studies recorded class, and as you know that we were currently discussing about our chapter, Our Country Pakistan, and it was a kind of a very interesting chapter as we got to know about so many things related to it, that how does we get all this freedom that we are living into, who were the leaders behind these struggles, and how did they actually got out of this whole situation to us, and how they provided this great land Pakistan to us. It was and we did discuss about you know, the issue related to that we are facing to in our country Pakistan nowadays. We discussed about how many provinces are there, and you know, how many types of provinces we actually live on. There are four provinces in Pakistan, and what are their capitals, what are their special places, like what are their landforms. We all discuss in that chapter. Now it's time for a wrap up kind of a thing, that is the question and answers that we are going to do in this recorded class. So you need to take out your social studies copies, and after taking out your copy, you need to make this title page. The first rule of starting of any work is to make a title page. So title page is of our country Pakistan, and I have attached this picture. I really loved it, and I really love this dark green color of our flag. It really does look good, and you can make different kind of things. You can you know, just paste the picture of map or anything, but I like this, which I obviously have attached a picture, but you need to draw, or you can just, you know, take simply just paste over it, or you can do whatever you like to do. You are very smart in this regard. So after completing our we will move to our main topic, that is topic question and answers. Date on the right hand side and CW on the right left hand side, right hand side, and date on the left hand side. Now topic question and answers is, so question number one is, write the names of few important Muslim leaders. Like, who were the few important Muslim leaders at that time? Answer is, following are few important Muslim leaders, out of which there were so many, but I have attached over three names of it I have written. Why? Because mostly these three were mainly focused in our chapter, so it will be easy for you to just discuss only three personalities. So the first one is Muhammad Ali Jinnah, means Qaid-e-Azam. Qaid-e-Azam means great leader. So he was a very great leader. This name was given to him by us people of Pakistan, that he is Qaid-e-Azam of ours. He is a great leader, Muhammad Ali Jinnah. Number two, Fatima Ali Jinnah, Madre Millat, means mother of the nation. Fatima Ali Jinnah was actually the sister of Qaid-e-Azam. Means Muhammad Ali Jinnah's sister, Fatima Ali Jinnah, and he she did work side by side and gathered all the women and empowered all the women to work towards this freedom movement, and that was very great kind of a look to actually see that women were side by side their men at this hard times, in these hard times. Number three is Allama Muhammad Iqbal. He is a national poet. In Urdu, you can also say him like Shair-e-Mashriq. He is also known as Shair-e-Mashriq. So number three, these are the three important personalities, like Muhammad Ali Jinnah, Fatima Ali Jinnah, and Allama Muhammad Iqbal. There are more than these people. Not only these three, but only these three were explained in this chapter. So that's why I have written only three names. Question number two is that, discuss the role of Qaid-e-Azam in the freedom movement. Like, what was the role of Qaid-e-Azam? Obviously, it was a great role. He did play a really great part in it. It was a kind of very detailed answer, but I try my level best to make it short for you, so that it will be easy for you to even understand it. So I attach main point to it. So the answer is, Qaid-e-Azam became a member of All India Muslim League. You know that All India Muslim League was made in response of Congress. Congress was the National Indian National Congress was a party that only basically focused for basic. First, it was just working for both of the nations. Then, it started gradually to work only for India only, and that's why this Muslim All India Muslim League was made, and he became the member of it and worked for Muslims. Then he represented his 14 points to save the political rights of Muslims. Now, why did he make this 14 points? He made this 14 points in response of to the Nehru report that was made by an Indian. Nehru was an Indian who made this report, and in that response he made his 14 points, in which he represented actually that what would be the political rights of the Muslims, what are they going to be, what main issue they were facing. So he just summed it up all in his 14 points. So as a result, his determination led Muslims to get a separate homeland. So many other things were done as well, and he, you know, he was the first Governor General of Pakistan as well after the separation of the India and Pakistan subcontinent, and he was the main leader. He is obviously the founder of our country, and because of his hard working, his determination, this led us to get a separate homeland. So this was the role of Qaid-e-Azam in the freedom movement. It's really short answer, but it will be very less to describe his role in just small lines. Okay. Question number 3, list the physical features of Punjab. Like, what are the physical features of Punjab? Physical features of Punjab are like, it has 5 important rivers. Those rivers names were Ravi, Satluj, Chenab, Jhelum, and Indus. I haven't written the name, wrote the name of it, but you should remember whenever I ask you that what are the 5 rivers of the Punjab, present in Punjab. So those are Indus, Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, and Satluj. Number 2, its land is fertile and used for agriculture. You know, the Punjab is actually mainly known as for its agricultural thing. Most of the crops are grown in that area because the land is very fertile. Fertile means the where the crops actually grow properly, jahan pe growth of the plants is very good. So the land is fertile and used for agriculture. Number 3, canals can be found throughout the provinces. There are so many canals that you can see all over the province in Punjab. Number 4, it has different landforms like Margila Hills, Salt Range, and Potwar Plateau. Moreover, then it has the Cholistan Desert as well. But I have written in part, you know, I have just written down this 3 to make it short and simple. So these are the 3 names, landforms that are present in. These are one of the physical features of Punjab, that has different landforms like Margila Hills, Salt Range, and Potwar Plateau. So these are the 4 physical features. It has 5 important rivers. Its land is fertile and used for agriculture. Canals can be found throughout the province, and it has different landforms like Margila Hills, Salt Range, and Potwar Plateau. So question number 4 is, describe the significance of the Pakistani flag and draw and color the flag. You need to draw and color it on the blank page. For drawing purposes, here there's your blank page should be used, and for writing purposes, the line wala part you can use. So question number 4 is, describe the significance of the Pakistani flag and draw and color the flag. You will draw and color the flag on the blank page. Answer is, a flag is a national symbol and the pride of a country. Like, it does represent that what country we are from, what part of the country we are from. You can just look at the flag and name the country that it's a Pakistani flag, it's a you know, American flag, it's a Turkish flag, Turkey's flag. So that's what it is. It represents the significance. It is a national symbol and pride of the country. So, Pakistani flag is actually of 2 colors, that is green and white. And the green part in Pakistani flag represents Muslims, and white part represents the people belonging to other religions. So, when the Pakistani flag was made, they surely did this. You know, they mainly thought that the major part of the flag that was. Green part is actually representing the Muslims, like we Muslims are living in Pakistan, that's the majority. And the white part that was little on it, side pe jo thoda sa white part hai, that actually represents the part for other religion people belonging to different religion, different beliefs and all that. So Qaed e Azam's main purpose was also that he thought that not only Muslims but all other religion people can live with us as well. We all will work side by side. Not only one Muslims will be that only in Pakistan, but different religion people can practice it freely. Kisi ko koi pressurize nahi kiya jayega. They can all practice their religion very properly. That was a very good point of Pakistan, Qaed e Azam, that all of the people are equal, whatever their religion is. Question number 5, that define the term constitution. Write two main characteristics of the constitution of Pakistan. Now the term constitution does seem a little difficult to hear, but it's very easy. That what's actually a constitution? A constitution is a set of laws that a country follows. Two main characteristics of the constitution of Pakistan are that what is constitution? Constitution is whenever you make a country or any organization or even you play a game, you need to set some rules, right? So if you set some rules, you need to be, you cannot just start the game and play like that. You need to set some rules to play that game, and for that you need to make some set of laws, a set of rules, like. So that's what constitution does, that for making, taking a whole new country to work in a proper platform, we need a constitution. And for that constitution, that means it's a set of laws that a country follows, and we all need to follow that constitution. And we are following the constitution of 1973, that was made in 1973. And two main characteristics, meaning two main parts of the constitution of Pakistan, were that the Pakistan country was named the Islamic Republic of Pakistan. Yes, that's the official name of our country, the Islamic Republic of Pakistan, and Urdu was declared as the national language of the country. Means, Urdu was the national language, Urdu was and is the national language of our country, and our country was named as Islamic Republic of Pakistan. There are so many other points as well, but they ask only two main characteristics, so that's why Islamic Republic of Pakistan country was named and Urdu was declared as the national language of the country. Now this question is to be done by yourself. You all need to do it yourself. Why? Because I want to know and hear that what problem, public problem that you have faced. Like describe any one public problem of your area and suggest a solution for it. Like if you can see that in our chapter pothole as well, we did see that there was a big pothole and there were so many lot of accidents over in that area. Similar kind of thing, like if there's water shortage, if there's electricity issue or any other issue that you are facing, that's a public problem, right? Not only you, all other people are facing that. So that's what they are asking, that any one public problem that your area is facing, the area where you are living in, and you need to suggest a solution for it as well. No need to write a detailed answer. Just try to write it short, just for 2-3 to 4 lines, not more than that. Maximum 5, not more than that, because it will be difficult for you to even learn it in future to answer this question in test or what. It will be easy for you to just write it short. So describe any one public problem of your area and suggest a solution for it. So ending this video with a very enthusiastic kind of a picture of Pakistan, like Pakistan Zindabad, long live Pakistan, may our country live long, and the spirit of ours for towards our country remains same, the love for our country of ours remains same. Pakistan lives long, and inshallah Pakistan will be one of the most developed countries soon, inshallah, if we all will own it. We all will work for it. We all will do betterment. We will all do the work for its betterment. And inshallah, it will be a very great country if we all will work together in this thing to make it more successful and more proper, prosperous country. So it's me, teacher, signing off. Till then, you all take care of yourself. Inshallah, we will just discuss these things in our live sessions as well. Till then, take care of yourself. Allah Hafiz.